the most recognizable flowers, at least in the grocery stores, you'll see beautiful bouquets of ones called freesia. Now, freesias are named after the German physician Friedrich Heinrich Theodor Fries, and they're bell-shaped blooms with a wonderful citrus smell. In the language of flowers, it's actually the 7th anniversary flower. So just in case you've got a 7th anniversary coming up, might be one that you want to put in your bouquet. So they've got a wiry stem, and I've had that here, with several blooms coming out on the end of it. And then you've got, it's a 6-petal flower, so you've got 2 different shapes. One goes on top of the other, offsetting, and you cut one of each, and then you've got your leaves and your stamen. So the first thing I want to do is put together that stem. Now, I've always cut 2, and because this is a green stem, I've got one in green and one in white, because I actually want to add a little bit of color to it with my Copic markers. So I'm just going along this green one so I can put the 2 together. You could also use a little bit of double-sided adhesive when you cut it out to put it together, but the glue works just as well and holds up nicely. Get this back together and grab my tweezers and put this right on top of that, aligning it just like so. Gives it a little bit of depth, and that's why I like to do it. So I'm going to color this one, the stem, in a lovely green here. And as you can see, these 4 little pieces here are actually blooms. So you'll be able to see the outline where you do your bloom and your cover up of what would be the calyx underneath. So I'm just adding a little bit there. This one's going to be a pink one. So I'm going to add a little bit of pink right in there so I can shade them. There you go. Okay. Before we get started on the flowers, let me show you. I'm taking my little detailed tweezers and just bending these a little bit to give them even more dimension. Just bending right around that tip, and it's rounding these really nicely. You could also bend these a little bit if you want to. Those are the little calyx that are going to hold the bloom. And then I'm going to apply some glue here right down that stem. And you can see I already have one bloom of freesia here, and I'm gonna make this one my pink one. So we're gonna have it coming up right there. I've made a lovely tent card with some daisy chrysanthemums to create the bouquet, and have my quote, "Flowers are like friends, they bring color to your world." This one would be a great one to do that with, because it really does have a lot of colors it comes in. So the petals, these here, I'm going to do, the other ones I did with Copic, these I'm gonna do with an archival ink and a finger dauber, and just go around the edges with that pink, leaving white areas. It's kind of a hot pink color. I think this is called cactus flower, but gives the coloration that I want using this dauber instead of a solid marker, because I want a lot of white showing on this one for this variety. But you've got some that are yellow, white, red with very hot red with a yellow or orangish yellow centers, purples and lavenders, orange, solid yellow, yellow with a little bit of orange. They really do come in some magnificent colors. So if you're not familiar with them, then just, you know, go ahead and Google it and see all the different colors the freesia come in. This is a nice one because it does have a nice long stem. And as you can see with the daisy chrysanthemums, you can add that to your bouquets really nicely. Always a little bit more detail. I'm using a little fine liner pen, and I'm going to add a few little striations of a lighter pink into this. Just the detail. Now these have, like I said, bell-shaped petals. So we're not going to put a lot of striations in them. I'm going to take and put them on my molding pad. And instead of using my leaf tool, I'm actually going to use my medium ball stylus. Now these are the bottom petals. And I'm just going to go around the petal and just soften it, reshaping the fibers of my specialty paper. These take, as you can see, it takes the inks really well, takes Copic markers. Just don't try the distressed oxides, because with the metal tips, you'll get gray streaking on your paper. It reacts with the oxide. Now, take your tweezers and we're going to pinch each one of these at the base. And if you like, you can bend down just a little bit to give it some shape. But they're really more bell shaped, so you can leave it, you know, I'm just going to turn that little tip down a bit. Oops. And you're going to repeat the same technique on this one. Just a little bit of turn down, pinching. You grab it with your opposite hand of your index finger and your thumb, and then use your really detailed or tweezers. These are my reverse tweezers, which kind of grab hold and let you use it as a vise. Now, grab your very small ball stylus and cup both of these. So, as you might guess, this one here, I'm going to dip a little bit of glue there, but you really only want glue on that center. And I'm going to find where my two petals are together, and I'm going to offset them into the flower like this. Now it's quite spread out, so what I've done is taken, this is a little egg tray for quail eggs, and pushed it down in there. So it will set and give you that bell-shaped flower. You can find these online if you're looking for them. Now for the stamen, it does have some yellow pollen, and you can always get your pollen and your prills at Spellbinders. So look them up. They're there to add the detail you need for your flowers. I'm just coloring this with a little lighter yellow instead of the deeper. And then I'm going to take my scissors and clip these in half before I roll it with my tweezer. So if you grab them and grab that little tail, and then I'm going to bring in some glue right on a toothpick here. Well, I need a new toothpick. That one's getting a little glumpy. So you just want a little bit of glue along that bottom edge, the straight edge, just enough to hold it together. And then it gets wound up and slid off your tweezer. I'm gonna frill out these filaments a little bit, dip it in the glue just on the edges, and then into my yellow pollen. Looks like one little escape guy there got. So we're gonna add a little bit more glue to that one and dip him there. And then I'm gonna take that off my fingers and get the glue off. But take your detailed tweezers. I'm gonna make sure there's no glue on them. And you just want to place it right on down into your flower. As you can see, I've placed these purple ones. Now I'm just going to grab some more glue and we're going to add our pink variety. I've done acetate on the window here as if you're looking out. You can also get your acetate at Spellbinder. So you can come along just on each one of those little areas there. I'm actually going to push that one down a little bit. I think we'll add some glue on to that before I put this flower. I want to make sure that stem is staying down so it doesn't pull my flowers back up again. So let me just hold that down a second and let the glue adhere. Grab my glue and place it right on that one there. And you see the nice, how they formed in that egg tray. They did get that bell shape. Doesn't take long. I use this for my tulips as well. Give a shout out to Heather for finding these and sending them along. And then our last one here can go right on the edge. Whoops. And press this down a little bit so I can make sure they're locked in. There we go. Now we have our flowers in place. Let's talk about those leaves. Like I said, you get a plate with the two leaves on it, and you can cut it out of the specialty paper and color them. But if you want to save your specialty paper, do as I do and cut them out with a nice green. So these do get a stem line, so I'm going to turn them over on the wrong side, and with my leaf tool coming down the center, just follow right down the center, that gives you your stem line. Now this one's very narrow, so it's going to take using your tweezer to fold it, bend it in that half, so you can color that or shade that stem line. And then I'm just going to grab some pan pastels here and add a little bit of color right down the center so you can really see that stem line. Back on the leaf pad and taking your leaf tool, these have, instead of veining, they have some striations. So just carefully go down that on either side of that stem line. And then you can use your tweezers again. Now you're going to bend up instead of bending down to bring that leaf in dimension. There, very easy. Now let's go ahead and place some on our project here and finish this up. Lift up some of these and again, it's up to your discretion how many leaves you want to add. If you want to cut, you know, a few more, you can. I've done just a couple more here to really give it some fullness. So you've got that lovely pink and lavender shades. Now we'll add our little ladybug to finish my project. I can add it right there. A little generous with that glue. Luckily it does dry clear. So I'm gonna let that go like that. Maybe take a toothpick and try to scrape some of that off. Be careful how generous you are. I get a little over, you know, she dipped in quite a bit, but like I said, it does dry clear, so it won't hurt anything. And then I wanna use a little bit of glaze to shine her shell. Boy, she's really gluey. But it'll all work out. I'll get some of that glue off. Oh, poor baby. Yeah. She's stuck on the leaf, that's for sure. A little messy. Not usually this messy. There we go. But that's a beautiful bouquet, adding some color and interest to your flowers with the freesia. It's a blooms in the spring, lasts a little bit longer in some areas that aren't as hot, but it's a great one to add to your bouquets.